First today, the Trump administration complaining about another legal hurdle to the president's signature agenda item, immigration. In a joint statement, the Departments of Justice and Homeland Security taking issue with a Monday ruling by a federal judge who says the president's new directive to deny asylum for immigrants who cross the southern border illegally is unconstitutional. The judge, John Tiger, issued a restraining order, effectively pausing the policy, and said this in his ruling. Whatever the scope of the president's authority, he may not rewrite the immigration laws to impose a condition that Congress has expressly forbidden. The legal setback comes at an interesting moment. Now that the election is over, gone are the constant warnings from the president about that migrant caravan winding through Mexico. But Customs and Border Protection officials yesterday did suspend northbound traffic at a key crossing point, adding control measures, funneling vehicles into fewer lanes. They said they did that because they had information some in the caravan planned to rush the border. Today, the Pentagon says its mission on the southern border has no specific timeline. Troops have already spent weeks there laying down barbed wire, among other things. But now, defense officials telling CNN the president expected soon to grant troops stationed there some new authority, that being to protect government personnel from migrants if they engage in violence. With me this day to share their reporting and their insights, Eliana Johnson of Politico, Bloomberg, Sahil Kapoor, Olivier Knox with SiriusXM, and Sungmin Kim with The Washington Post. It's the judge in San Francisco. The administration has the right to appeal, which would go back to one of the president's favorite places, the Ninth Circuit. But this is another setback for the administration, which says we will use executive power to impose our will to change immigration policy, and a court saying can't do that.
We have repeatedly seen this throughout the Trump administration, particularly as it pertains to immigration. We've seen that the courts have been this kind of bulwark against these executive actions, whether it's this latest asylum directive, the multiple iterations of the travel ban, the last version of which did actually get upheld by the Supreme Court, sanctuary cities, also DACA. And we knew once the asylum directive was drafted that it would get challenged in the courts. Now the temporary restraining order is only through December 19th, so it's a question to see whether the administration kind of goes back and reworks their directive to see whether they could write it in a way that does get upheld by the courts, but clearly a setback for the administration here.
Yeah, and you know, the reason that we've seen the president and the administration use executive orders is that nothing has happened in Congress on immigration. So the president has been frustrated with that. He wants to flex his muscles on immigration, and he's said, I want to draft executive orders and let them sue me. And that's precisely what's happened, essentially. But right now, we're getting mixed signals on what the administration's strategy is going to be. We have had the president tell troops on the border he's giving them more authority to do what they want. But my Politico colleague, Wesley Morgan, also reported yesterday that the Pentagon is going to start pulling troops away from the southern border. And we've also seen a shift in the president's focus away from saber-rattling immigration rhetoric and more towards bipartisanship. So I don't think it's at all clear what strategy the immigration or the administration will pursue legally going forward here.
At the heart of all of this, it's important to remember that there's a mismatch between the mandate coming from Congress and the resources that the administration has to carry out that mandate. So President Obama looked and said, I'm required by law to deport all 11 million people here illegally, but DHS only has the authority to deport about 400,000. He decided I'm going to protect maybe 4 million people from that deportation. The courts shot him down. Now President Trump looks and says, there's a massive backlog. The immigration courts are jammed up, so I'll create a new category. Now what the courts are saying is that there are only two categories by which the government can exclude people on asylum. One is you have to have a well-founded fear of persecution to get in, and you have to make sure the person is not a danger to the U.S. The judge is saying that the administration is creating a third category by saying you have to enter in a certain place. Now the AG has discretion at the end of the day, in spite of all the categories, which is what the DHS argument is.
And to Eliana's point about where's the president going to go on this, during the campaign it was the invaders, they're coming, there are unknown Middle Eastern people there, they're bad guys, this is a threat, we have to do something about it. Does he change his tone after the election is one interesting thing, or does he now take out, because he gets mad at this judge, start yelling at Congress, where's my border wall funding? And the thing I just want to put, Monmouth asked the question about the caravan. The president talked about it repeatedly. Some Republicans put it in their campaign ads late in the campaign. Do you think the migrant caravan poses a major threat, minor threat, or no real threat to the United States? Major threat, 3 in 10 Americans. Minor threat, 24%. No real threat, 4 in 10. So there's a divide against, essentially, I'm guessing that breaks down along pretty partisan lines.
If you remember that sort of contentious November 7th press conference, there were a lot of different variations, a lot of different answers to your question about which direction the president goes in. Is he conciliatory? Does he threaten? Does he bluster? Does he get angry? Does he say, I don't want to talk about a shutdown right now. Does he say, I'd be perfectly happy to have a shutdown? This is something that's been echoing across the president's public appearances since the election. And I don't think we have a real answer, but I would suggest that the last, I don't know, 3 years of people saying, aha, Donald Trump will now pivot and change his ways, might be instructive here. I don't think that they're gonna bow away, they're gonna shy away from these fights. I think quite the contrary. I think they're gonna be seeking them out.
And yeah. Remember too that the campaign season isn't quite over yet. The president does have campaign rallies coming up in Mississippi for the runoff election there. I would not be surprised if this resurfaces as a theme in those rallies.
That's a pure electoral strategy. I mean, the talk of the caravan arguably helped Republicans in deep red areas in states like Missouri and Indiana and North Dakota. The exit polls found that Republicans voters overall who cited immigration as their top issue voted for Republicans by 52 points. That's an enormous margin.
Enormous margin where it helps, and it does help in red areas. You could talk to soon-to-be former Congressman Carlos Curbelo of Southern Florida, and he would tell you he got hurt.
He didn't want the embrace.
He did not want the embrace. But to your point about don't expect the president to change, maybe for a day or two. But this on this issue in particular, immigration and trade, the president's fairly consistent about what he wants to do. He tweeted this out yesterday, and the border wall funding is a big issue. Congress has to pass a year-end spending bill. The president tweets out, the fake news is showing old footage of people climbing over our ocean area fence. This is what it really looks like. No climbers anymore under our administration. Now, you would expect criticism from the left on that, but how about this from Ann Coulter, who is thinks the president has dropped the ball here. Today's border wall construction update. Miles completed yesterday, zero. Miles completed since inauguration, zero. Next update, tomorrow. So on the right, there's a lot of disappointment that, you know, the president hasn't fought harder for this money, and a lot of disappointment that when the president says we're building the wall, they know that's simply not true.
Yeah, I mean, it's not just on the right. The president himself is frustrated that he has not gotten the funding for a border wall. He's acutely aware of it. And I would refer back to the last fight for funding over the border wall, where the president agreed to an omnibus spending bill that greatly increased domestic spending, rare under a Republican president who has talked the way he has, and then saw the criticism on Fox News. That was in public, and said he regretted signing that spending bill. And I wondered the extent to which that experience that will weigh on his mind as he approaches signing another government spending bill and thinks he doesn't want to make the same mistake again.
And this is his last shot. Democrats are going to take control of the House in January, and they're going to impose a very different set of demands than Republicans have so far on what he's going to get for his border wall and what he has to give up for it. The thing that President Trump has wanted in all of these deals is cuts to legal immigration, cuts to family sponsorship and things like that. Democrats are not going to back down on that. They will give him his wall for some sort of a DACA deal, as far as my reporting suggests, but not the legal immigration cuts. And that's only going to get worse for the president.